Hello, the four knight f6, f4 c6, knight c3, bishop b4 c3, castles, bishop d3 d5 c3, bishop c3, b takes c3 dc, bishop c4 c5, knight f3, and we go win c7. And now white has some moves. Bishop d3 now is mistake because cd, cd, and queen c3, and boy queens, a rook or a bishop. So not so many options. Knight d2 protecting the bishop is not looking very good, but it's playable. e5, castles, rook d8, bishop b2, knight c6, rook c1, cd, cd, ed, ed, and here black should have developed the bishop with bishop f5, knight f3, and bishop b4 is an equal position. Bishop b3. Now it's interesting to make new move b5. Not b6 because bishop is somehow misplaced on b3. If now a4, then cd, cd, and b4, castles and a5, and black cannot be worse with such pawn structure. For example, bishop b2, knight bd7, rook c1, queen d8, knight d2, knight e5, knight e5, d, knight d5 is an equal position. So knight d2, bishop b7, f3, bishop d5, exchanging the bishops. White. Well, bishop c2, we play knight b6, black has no problems. Castles. Then we go bishop b7, queen e2, rook c8, bishop d2, and knight bd7. The position is equal. So knight e5, knight bd7, knight d7, queen d7, f3. But we change bishops. Bishop d5, bishop c2, and white goes here. That bishop c4, rook f2, rook fd8, bishop b2, a5, e4, and rook ac8. And black is better in this position. Queen c2 is another move to take on cd. We go b6, bishop d3. Of course, now castles is bad because cd, cd, bishop a6. And we win the exchange. Bishop b2, cd, cd, bishop a6, bishop d3. That was old Petrosyan again in Seeker game. And here black should have played queen c2. Bishop c2, knight c6, rook c1, and rook a8, and black is just better because white cannot castle. So bishop d3, but now we can play bishop a6, exchanging the bishops, and we have no problems. For example, castles is inaccuracy, cd, ed, bishop d3, queen d3, and rook c8, and black is better, of course, at such position. So bishop a6, knight a6, and queen d3. So game between Medina and Pommer, and here black should have played logical knight b8, castles, knight c6, c4, and h6 with a balanced position. Queen d3. I like queen b3, but protecting against bishop a6 ideas. But okay, we go b6 with the idea of playing bishop b7. So castles, bishop b7, knight d2, knight c6, bishop a2, rook fd8, queen e2, cd, cd, and a5, and black looks better in Mirzoyev-Pogarev game. If e4 now, then bishop b7, e5, Lee against Lupulescu, and here black should have played bishop e4 first, provoking queen e2, bishop f3, because now g takes f3 is not so great idea. Knight d5 attacking the pawn, rook g1, rook c8, bishop h6, g6, bishop d5, ad, queen s3, and knight c6, and black is much better. So queen f3, cd, castles, queen c4. Now queen a8, knight c6, queen b7, rook b8, queen c7, knight d5, queen d7, and dc, and black wins the queen in the nearest future. So it takes f6, queen d5, queen g3, g6, g1, knight c6, queen f4, queen f5, exchanging the queen. So black is just better in this line. So let's try usual moves. Not bishop d3, but bishop e2 in this position, and bishop a2. They are both logical. If bishop a2, then comparing with the bishop b3 move, we go just b5. that's the difference between the setups with knight on f3 and knight e2. When knight is on e2, we go b6, bishop a6. When knight is on f3, we go b5. Castles, bishop b7. If now knight g5, then knight bd7, f3, h6, knight h3, and the knight is misplaced now. Bishop d5, bishop b1, bishop c4, rook f2, and e5, and rook was better. Savchenko pretty game. If bishop b1, well, maybe it's better move than queen e2. So let's start with. Let's go with bishop b1, knight bd7, queen e2, knight e4, bishop b2. Bishop c6, protecting the pawn, bishop d3, and rook ap8, rook is slightly better. So the main move is queen e2, and here black should try rook c8, that's a novelty. If now bishop b2, knight bd7, rook fc1, knight b6, knight e5, and knight fd7, the equal position. If bishop b1, then knight c6. If queen b5, then okay. Knight a5, queen c5, queen c5, dc, and rook c5, and book as full compensation was sacrifice pawn. So bishop b2, knight a5, e4, knight c4, bishop c1, knight d7, protecting against e5. If now a4, then cd, cd b4, bishop d3, and a5, and book is better. So bishop d3 is slightly better, but knight db6, rook e1 and h6 with complex and equal position. Right, I can also try rook d1, but we give this pawn, knight bd7, queen b5, because we have this knight g4 idea. D5 really the only move. Bishop d5, bishop d5, ad, rook d5, knight df6, rook d1, knight e4, attacking the pawn, queen c4, rook d8, rook f1, queen f7, h3, and knight gf6, and black has full compensation for the sacrificed pawn. Just look at poor bishop on c1. That was bishop a2. Bishop b2 is the main move. We go knight c6. Well, of course, we know what to do. Knight c6 and e5 at some point. Castles, rook d8. If now c4, then b6, bishop b2, old game. Passman tile here. Black should have played knight a5. Queen c2, bishop b7. If rook fd1, then cd, ed, rook ac8, knight d2, and queen f4, and black is better. So knight e5, knight d7, knight d7, and rook d7 is an equal position. If bishop b2, then e5, queen c2, bishop g4 is a transposition to the queen c2 move. So rook c1, bishop g4, h3, bishop h5, knight e5, bishop e2, bishop e2. Knight e5, d, queen e5, c4, otherwise white is in problems, but queen e6 is in a good position. So queen c2, we go e5, bishop b2, and bishop g4, that was our main idea. And now some games from these positions, for example, Harifman-Kramnik. But let's start from fresh games. h3. That's logical move. Bishop h5. Now knight e5, knight e5, d. Black has good move. Bishop g6 intermediate. And queen b3, that was an inaccuracy. Knight e4, c4, and knight d2. And black won an exchange in the game. Vaznichka Karyakin. So d takes e5 is better. Try. Knight e5, knight e5, bishop e2, queen e2, queen e5, c4, queen e6, rook fd1. Knight e4, rook ac1, b6, f3, knight g3, queen f2, and knight f5. That's a standard position where white has a bishop, but black can play f6 at some point, and white has weak e3 and c4 pawns. Let's make some more moves. e4, knight e7, queen g3, f6, Mozharov, Zhitkov game. Here white should have played f4, sacrificing the pawn, but it's an equal position after queen e4, bishop f6, rook d1, rook d1, knight g6, bishop b2, queen f4, queen f4, knight f4, rook d7, knight h5. Yes, white has full compensation for the sacrifice pawn, but it's just a drawish position. So d takes f5 is my move. Knight f5, c4, knight f3, g takes f3, bishop h3, rook fd1. So now black should know what to do because white has a pair of bishops. We play queen c6, and in the game Halfman misplaced against Kramnik and played queen c3. Now just knight e8 protecting against queen g7. King h1, bishop e6, rook g1, f6, rook g3, rook d7, rook h1, rook d8, and black was slightly better. So king h1 is better try, but now it's a perpetual check. Knight g4, rook d8, rook d8, e4, knight e2, king g1, and good move, queen h6, king f2, rook d2, queen c3, queen g5, king e1, rook d4, not the perpetual check, but the repetition of move. King f2 and rook d2, when you analyze with engines, you see such lines sometimes with 0.0. So let's make some conclusions about knight f3 and queen c7 line. If white goes to b3 or a2, we play b5, bishop b7 with the idea of playing bishop to d5. If white goes bishop e2, then the normal stuff, knight c6, rook d8, and e5, with the idea of playing bishop g4. So really, I think in this position, so white should be careful, because, well, yes, white has a pair of bishops, but black's play is very easy. And white can have some problems with the bishop on c1. So that's all about the Botvinnik system with a3, and in the next videos we'll talk about main line of the Rubinstein system when white goes knight f3. Stay tuned and see you again soon. Goodbye.